Have you ever said, I knew that was going to happen? I've had that. I knew it, and I couldn't explain it, and I wished I'd listened to it. It was my intuition telling me. Well, now I do listen to it, and I discovered there are three big ways I use my intuition to help me every day. In this episode, I'm going to go over all three.
Welcome to Between Heaven and Earth, an internet radio talk show where we help you connect spirit and divine guidance. Lisa Kay, your host, brings you shows that can enhance and transform your life with tips and new ideas for more happiness, abundance, and better relationships. Lisa is an expert on intuition and can show you how to strengthen your inner guidance to empower yourself. Each show is positive and uplifting to inspire your day. Her guest speakers are specialists on self-help, positive thinking, spirituality, and conscious living. Be the best that you can be with Between Heaven and Earth, conscious living for your soul.
So what is it that your intuition can do for you? Well, your intuition is like your ace in the hole, that special sauce, your extra something, your magic within, that asset, that superpower that we can all draw on. So how do you draw on that magic to your advantage? Remember that your intuition and intuitive mind is always working and always providing you information, just as your thinking mind does. To use your intuition, you need to pull out your ace in the hole, so to speak, when you need it. Now, have you ever had any of these situations happen to you? Maybe there's a coworker at work who is in competition with you, or perhaps is just plain difficult. And every time you face them, conflict begins, or their actions feel like wordless attacks on you. Another situation may be where you need to make a decision fast because you have to act right now. And you're overwhelmed with information, the pros and the cons, and the possible effect it might have on other people. And then you get into analysis paralysis. You can't decide. Or perhaps you're in the store making a purchase and the store salesperson gives you so many options to choose from, your head's spinning and you're not quite sure which ones to pick. In all these situations, you'll want to know the best thing to say or do to your advantage and take the right action. Here's another one. You have that funny feeling, or you have an uncomfortable sense in your gut, and you know your intuition is trying to tell you something. It's trying to warn you of something, but you don't know what it is. It might be when you're in a new place, or a stranger that you encounter, or maybe that new person that you just met. What is it? What is that feeling trying to tell you? Is it your intuition warning system that's saying, this isn't right, or be on the lookout? Another case might be where you're in someplace new or you just met someone and you didn't feel anything. You didn't have that gut feel, but you want to know more about them or the place. You want to get to know before you need to know about the situation or the person or the place. Or you might have a situation and you want to know the outcome before there is an outcome. This is where you can use your intuition to give you the advantage. This doesn't mean that you throw away your logic and your thinking, but you kind of merge and meld your thinking mind with your intuition. So here are the three things that intuition can do for us. And this is what I discovered and how I use my intuition on a daily basis with these three ways. Number one, being our warning system for things we need to be on the lookout for or people we need to keep an eye on. Perhaps your intuition's telling you that you need to seek out more help or you need to make an important change to avoid disaster. Number two, intuition can gather intelligence, right, intel, or information for us in a way that's deeper, more honest and true than what we can just by talking to people or reading about a situation or a person. Intuition has a way of knowing and telling us what cannot be seen or easily found out. I know way more about a person through my intuition than I would just talking or hanging out with them. Number three, you can apply your intuition to help you make better decisions. Your intuition has the ability to give you answers that not only lead to a better result, but leave you feeling confident and lead you to the best results all the time. When you can lean into your intuition and go with it, your decisions are so awesome that you never regret ignoring your intuition again. You don't go back and forth. You don't second guess yourself. You move forward with clarity and confidence. You just know it's right. You trust yourself. And that's what intuition can do in terms of the help we need when we make decisions. So the three things, again, in summary are: it can be our warning system for things we need to be on the lookout for. Number two, it can gather intelligence or information for us in a way that's deeper and more honest and true. And number three, you can apply your intuition to help you make better decisions. So some of the first steps you can take to start using your intuition to help you with these three things are these. Number one, take a step back, so to speak. When you're in the thick of a situation, often your emotions are running, you feel pressed or anxious as you deal with it, you have to remember to pause and tap into your intuition. Number two, give your thinking mind pause and ask your intuition to give you guidance on the next step or decision to make. What information is your intuition picking up about the situation, the place, or person that you aren't hearing about or immediately seeing? Number three, your intuition will respond in her language, which can be made up of a piece of an image or a feeling or a word. And when you understand her language and you know how to get meaning from it, you can use it to make better decisions, because intuition is coming from another part of you in your brain that has key information you need. It can also tap into that divine message that you might need to hear right then. So, in summary, to work best with my intuition, I use a technique to get my intuition to appear when I need it so I can tap into it instantly. When I'm too emotional to hear my intuition clearly, I use what I call an intuition tool. And that can work to get your thinking mind out of the way. Intuition tools are perfect for helping you tap into your intuition more precisely and pointing you towards the best course of action. So there are two things. I use a technique and a tool, and that's what helps me use my intuition on a daily basis to do those three things we talked about. So the next time you have a tough situation, you can use your intuition to your advantage to get you going in the right direction. You know, I always think it's nice to have that extra help to give you that edge. Now, I teach all of these tools and techniques in a class called Trust Yourself. And the Trust Yourself, it's actually a course. The Trust Yourself course is going to be opening the doors soon. And if you want to get a taste of what it's like to be in the Trust Yourself course, come and join my free Making Decisions with Your Intuition workshop. Just go to intuitionmasteryworkshop.com and you can sign up there. We're actually starting tomorrow. And if you're listening to this podcast after this would be May 24th, then you can still listen to some of the replays, but it's only going to be up for a few days. So I suggest you go and sign up as soon as you can. Intuitionmasteryworkshop.com. And the replays are only up for a few days, and then they come down. But I do this, basically once a year. The course opens once a year, and then we do this nice free workshop in the beginning just to get you going. So intuitionmasteryworkshop.com, sign up, join me. I'd love to see you in the workshop and start to get you going on using your intuition for all these things, your warning system, gathering intelligence and information, and applying it to make better decisions. I'm Lisa Kay, and you've been listening to Between Heaven and Earth Radio, Conscious Living for Your Soul. Thanks for listening, everybody.